Hey girls, Taylor Bentson here at Team Zero Gravity again, going into another segment of our bikini posing. Today we're going to be talking more along the lines of transitions into that back pose. Now, last time we talked just about the main front pose and kind of etiquette poise with the judges. So today again, going over transitions and the main back pose. Amazing job by Judy. Now, how do you turn around to the back? It seems so simple, but it's not. The main point with getting into the back pose is the transitions. So, main part about transitions is timing and eye contact. Nothing will catch your eye if I hit my front pose and then immediately just go to the back pose. You want to slow down the transition, capture the judge's eye, and make them continue watching. Now, to get to the back, you have to step into what's called our transitional pose, which is the basic pose number one. You pop into pose number one before turning around to the back. What you want to do when turning to the back is it's a small, small step. It's more of a pivot to the back rather than a step. If I step, then all my weight is pushing the glutes down and not out. So with a smaller step, I'm able to push the glutes, keeping them lifted. Everything wants to stay up, nothing down. Just like that. Good, now let's go back, show the transition one more time. Again, feet are started in a T. You're gonna take one small pivot and step and turn. Again, main thing is keeping eye contact with the judges, so you're drawing that connection. Swing the feet around, stepping and transitioning. You're just going to take that back leg and open it up. I found that's the easiest way to get the feet back in the same line, rather than taking too many steps on stage and risking anything jiggly. It's best to plant this leg, swing this foot around, and already be in an arched position. Good. And then she just draws that other foot right back around. Everything's already lifted and already in that back pose. All right, now that we've transitioned to the back pose, the main thing you want to do in your back pose is keep feet shoulder width apart. We never want to widen the feet too much. Again, the judges do not like to see the straddle pose, which is the feet wide. Why? Because the judge is going to be sitting below you. They're not directly at the same level. So if they're below you and you're hitting this angle, it's not going to be a pretty view. So we keep the feet shoulder width apart, and you always want to make sure that your feet are slightly turned out. Good, just like that. Now if you have more dominant quads, you might want to keep the toes straight. It just depends on how your legs are built and the different sizes of the legs. But for this video, we like to show toes slightly pointed out. And again, with the back pose, it's a small tilt. It's not a bend. Judges being below you, you have no upper body now. So with the back pose, I always tell my girls it's like the feeling of doing a deadlift. So you're pushing just like if I was to be doing a deadlift, but you're also going to keep the shoulders pressed up. So we'll show them a side view. Step to the side and just hit your back pose. As you can see, again, feet shoulder width, toes slightly out. Her hips are bent towards the floor just like she's doing a deadlift, but her shoulders are going to be arched in a C position to keep the length of her body and stay very, very tall while she's hitting this back pose. The hand placement is right on the front of the suit, face back to the back. You don't want to see fingers on the edges of the hands, and you don't want to see fingers popping through the legs. You only want the hands to be soft. Again, you have the tan on, so you don't want to sponge his hand. Hands are soft on the front of the suit and pushing off the legs to really help you arch that back. And that's the basic of backflips.